Hey, what's going on, guys? Dave the Usher here. We're doing another cartoon commentary on Transformers Robots in Disguise, the 2015 series. And this is going to be for episode 9, titled Rumble in the Jungle. Okay, good stuff. Let's go. Let's get to it. I'm just going to tell you again. Some of you know, some of you don't know. In the video description below, and I'm actually kind of simplifying things lately, too. So, recently, I just wanted to make things easier because it's too complicated. So, hopefully this will make things better. But, yeah, in the video description below, because this show has not yet aired yet everywhere, or this episode at least, or whatever. In the video description below, there's a link to my personal Facebook page. My personal Facebook page, and that will set you up. You'll be good. It's all you need. Just to go to my personal Facebook page. Oh, you can like me and follow me on there, too. Because I'm so super interesting and cool. And so awesome. Yeah. But, that's all you need to do. That's all you need to do. And hopefully you stick around after you get what you need to get. You stick around and you watch with me. Or you watch and then after you watch again with me. Or before. However, whatever configuration you want to do, go for it. But yeah, we're going to watch episode 9, Rumble in the Jungle, and we're going to talk about things. I just actually finished recording an update video about my personal life, so you'll probably find that a couple vids before this video. So if you want to go to my main page, if you're interested in my personal life, go to my recent vid tab or whatever, and just it won't take you more than a couple seconds to find my latest update vid. Check it out. Talk a lot about some stuff, including some Transformer stuff, just so you know. So we're going to watch this in sync. How? Well, I'm going to start playing, and then I'm going to say like the first several seconds out loud, so you match your video's first several seconds to mine, and that's like in sync. In sync! Ah. So here we go. My video, episode 9, is a total of 21 minutes and 36 seconds. So here we go. And I'm going to play. Ready? Play. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 seconds for episode 9. Okay, so that should be good enough. And if you don't get it on the first attempt, do it back and sync up again. So Strongarm, Cadet Strongarm, that is her rank. She is Strongarm, Autobot, Cadet. Cadet, that means rookie. Youth, young, immature, inexperienced, all the above, one or two, whatever. Yeah, Strongarm, she's a by-the-books bot, and she's eager to please, and a go-getter, but yeah, by the book, and not a lot of experience, though. Cadet Strongarm. So, Rumble in the Jungle, I'm expecting a rumble, maybe with Strongarm. This seems to be a Strongarm-centric episode. Last episode was kind of like a Grimlock-centric episode. You know how it goes. Cartoons always do that, and shows do that, you know? Pick a couple characters, 1, 2, 3, whatever, and center it around them, you know, and build up some character stuff, and now we know Strongarm! You, who? Now, and after this, we'll know Strongarm just a little more. For better or for worse? I don't know. I'm having some coffee. I need it today. I'm leaving, I say this in my update video, but I'll say it again real quick. I'm leaving for my wedding. It's afternoon on Monday while I'm shooting this video. I'm leaving for my wedding in Vegas, where my fiance is, in 12-ish hours. Tomorrow, actually, about exactly a day, I'll be preparing the land, pretty much. Ooh, fun. And it's good because West Coast is 3 hours, or at least where I'm going, it'll be 3 hours behind. That'll be nice. You get that. You get 3 hours back. That's a nice thing. Traveling to the West, I feel, is definitely better than traveling to the East, because then you lose those hours, right? But whatever.
That has nothing to do with this,
right, Bailey? I know my buddy boy. He's I put him up at a fancy pet hotel here. I got him the best. It's pretty good. I don't know, Bailey. Sorry, bud. I'll be back in 8 days, about a week. What's going on? I'm going to get you a haircut, and You're going to be... I got you taken care of. I got him the best room. And I got him extra play time. You know, I got him, like, 3 play occasions throughout the day. Got your food ready, man. You're going to have your dog treats and everything. You're going to be taken care of, buddy boy. So anyway, we're watching Transformers. We're watching Transformers Robots in Disguise. 2015 series. Hey, look, toy stuff. Toys. This brings me to my first topic, I guess, right? This is Transformers Robots in Disguise 2015 series. Do I have to keep saying that? This is Transformers RID Prime. Optimus Prime. Glare stuff's probably happening, but what can you do? Hey, look, it's Prime. Not like a huge fan of this show, and this show is definitely... I mean, the toys kind of have a simplistic... Kind of almost... am I wrong? Transformers animated style? I don't know. It just seems similar. This seems different from Prime, Transformers Prime, which was a little more complex. This seems more like on par with Transformers Animated. You know, a different style and maybe a little more on the simplistic side. Does that make sense? But you should be able to see a little bit. And that brings me to my first topic, kinda. And this is what I do. I babble about stuff that's not even happening. But I'll get to this. I'll get to the episode. I got some points to make on this episode. But anyway, I just started collecting again, kinda, you know, and I'm a collector, I'm a Transformers fan, but here's the thing, you know, when did I stop collecting? When did I kinda, like, halt production on being interested in collecting? I have so many Beast War figures, I got like 90% of Beast Wars, not counting the Japanese stuff, or any, you know, like, where he's from. But I have, like, 90% of the Beast Wars figures from the 90s, and, like, 90% of Beast Machines, and I was so into Beast Wars, and I was so into Beast Machines, and all of that, and I was into those shows so much. I remember being at BotCon 2001. Even the actors were so into that show, you know? Like, it's a job, but it can be fun. Like, I made a comment about this in another one of my projects, Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix. When the voice actors are reading the dialogue, like they are right here, do you think they always know what the hell they're talking about, basically? Like, come on, we have to stop the Heartless. The Nobodies are coming, and we're going to get them, and we got to go, and come on, Sora, hurry up, blah, 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 yada, yada, words, words, words. And then they're like, what is the Heartless? Nobody, what is going on? I don't know. You know, because they don't see a video game. They don't see things. They don't totally know. They know certain stuff because they're told certain stuff, but they don't know everything. They're not playing a game. They're not fans. They may not be fans like you and me. You know how it is. It's a job. So they could be like, I don't know what's going on in this show. Like these guys, maybe. Or, you know, I was at BotCon 2001, and... there was Transformers actors there. From Generation 1, there was Michael Bell and Greg Berger and John Stevenson. And for Beast Wars, for the Beast Wars panel, voice actor-wise, there was Scott McNeil and Gary Chalk. And it wasn't just a job for those guys because... And I'm getting as to why I'm bringing this up because I'm getting kind of sidetracked. By the way, that's our featured episode's Decepticon. He kind of... looks like Spidor, Slapper from Transformers RID B01 series. I can't remember his name, but it's not any of those. But anyway, Gary Chalk and Scott McNeil were there, and I remember they were being asked questions like, are you going to be in the new Transformers Robots in Disguise show, 2001 series? And, you know, are you going to be in that? Are you going to be in that? Because Beast Machines just ended, and the actors, Scott McNeil and Gary Chalk, were up there like, oh, we don't know, you know. Like, they've been asked this many times, but they weren't like, oh, we don't know, shut up. And then they were just like, oh, we don't know. We wish we knew. We wish we knew, we just don't know, and blah, blah, blah. And yeah, they used different voice actors. It was a dubbed show, and they went with dubbed actors. And, you know, there's some talented... cool dubbed actors there as well. I'm not nitpicking on that or anything. It's just that, yeah, they ended up using different actors. And then that kind of relates to my whole philosophy, or not philosophy, but my original point is that when the 2001 series of R.I.D. came out, they started airing the cartoon, and then, well, what do? You start putting out the toys. Actually, toys are usually first. But, yeah, I'm collecting Beast Wars and Beast Machines, and Beast Machines, it went down, too. Like, I was collecting them, and they got goofy. They got goofy, and some of them are stupid and goofy. A lot of repaints. Some of them were cool. But a lot of goofy stuff, repaint stuff, and, like, remember Supreme Cheetor, or just regular Cheetor, Mega Cheetor, and then Supreme Nightscream, and, like, oh, I remember the first Optimus Primal? What was that worst Optimus Primal ever? Ever. What was worse? None were that bad. That was the worst Optimus Primal ever released. No way any of them topped that one. No. But I still collected them. And then, you know, I wasn't really digging that show of R.I.D. Wasn't digging this new show, and it was a dubbed, goofy show. It was even more goofy, and it wasn't my thing. And, you know, the toys weren't even that great. And then, like, I didn't like the characters, I didn't like the show, I didn't like any of it. So, why am I buying this? You know, I'm a big fan, mega fan. But why am I buying it? Why are you gonna buy it? If you're not a crazy fan of it, you know? And I stopped for a long time. You know, I was like, I'm not into this. I'm just not. And I watched a little R.I.D., and then Transformers Armada came, and it was in the dubbed kind of fashion, too, and all that. And I gave Armada way bigger chance. And then the following stuff came and just kind of fell out of it. And then I gave Transformers Animated a chance. I was really hyped about that one, and it kind of wasn't what I was expecting. Not to say the show was bad. And then Transformers Prime kind of brought it back to a certain level. Where, like, yeah, that's right. So then you have this, and then, I know, like, I'm not a crazy nut about this show, and then why do I have this then? Because I am a collector, you know, you buy, you sell, you buy, right? That's what collectors do, right? And that's not what's going on in this episode, totally, collecting. I thought one of the shows was going to be about that, with that collector guy, but that didn't really turn out to be the case. By the way, the whole subplot here is kind of a Turf Wars thing with this kid's dad and, was it Grimlock or Sideswipe? And they're just kind of butting heads about the turf of this junkyard. And I think a little self-worth as far as that goofy father figure goes. Like, hey, you know, I'm not just some dork. I'm doing something here important. I'm helping out. Like, I'm supplying this place to you guys. And I'm useful, too. And, you know, he's trying to have self-worth and show his self-worth, and then just, I guess, a turf thing. Like, this is my property, and hey, listen, guys, don't just think this place is stupid because it means a lot to me. Whatever. That's going on with Grimlock and Sideswipe and the others. We have something else going on here with Strongarm and Bumblebee. And I'm getting back. Did I finish this whole thing up? I think I did. Let's get back to the plot of the show, and I was going to talk about something in regards to this episode. You have Strongarm. What is she? She's the cadet. She's the weathered rook. She's novice. She's young. She's this. She's that. Okay, we get it. They've done this sort of thing a lot throughout media, and, well, just Transformers in general. Oh, let's get the examples going. What are the examples from any Transformers show, pick one. And I, of course, I got one. Of, like, a novice-type character. And you got, like, you got a couple of those episodes where it's the novice-centric character, and they get into trouble, and then maybe they end up redeeming themselves or saving the day or whatever. And, of course, because I'm a big Beast Wars fan, I'm going to mention, this black shirt takes all of your dog hair away, Bailey. I'm a big Beast Wars fan, so I'm going to mention Beast Wars, of course, and, of course, Cheetor. And, you know, it's funny, you can kind of relate Cheetor to Strongarm, I guess, in this episode, because they were both the rookies, but also Bumblebee, because Bumblebee was kind of the rookie. He was the scout. He's kind of the rookie, or more inexperienced character, I guess, in Transformers Prime, and now he's calling the shots. He's leading the army, right? And that's what happened to Cheetor, too, throughout Beast Wars and in the Beast Machines. And I wanted to talk about the examples, because that's what I do. Speaking of voice actors, this and that, like talking about how certain ones can just enjoy their work so much, like the Beast Wars actors were just so into it. They, and not only did they do it, because that's their job, but they loved it. They did it and love it. I don't know who the voice actor of this guy is. I don't know. I usually can tell you, but as far as this one goes, I don't have that knowledge. I feel like they should give him, like, that reptilian Scott McNeil voice, like that. You're trying to touch my treasure. You'll get burned. Ah. Yeah. Sounds a little generic, doesn't he? Maybe not my voice exactly, but... Or maybe my voice. Yeah, that'd be fine by me. But, yeah, I don't know. Sometimes, just be hit or miss. What's his name? It's not Spitter, it's not Slapper. In his search for what? He's searching for a scroll. In his search for what? What was that name? That name, he said, actually sounded like something familiar. I don't know if I misheard something there. Whatever. Maybe you guys can shed some light. What was I talking about? Okay, yeah, Beast War examples with Cheetor. I think I actually brought up this episode. What was it called? Tangled Web? It was like Season 1, Episode 4. It was right away, and Cheetor came across like a mega gun, a mega weapon from the crash, you know, scattered debris, a big weapon. He came across it. He's like, ooh, hey, Optimus, how you doing? This is Cheetor. Hello. I found the big gun, and I'm going to get it. And hooray, we got a big gun to get the Predacons with. And Optimus is like, hey, Brad, just chill back a little bit. Wait till, kind of chill. Wait for reinforcements so we can secure this thing. And Cheetor's like, no, man, I got it. And then he tries to get it, and whoop, stumbles on to, actually, Scorponok beat him to it. He stumbles on to Scorponok, and he encounters Scorponok, and then Tarantula shows up and kind of ambushes Cheetor, and then Scorponok capitalizes on Cheetor's error. And Buka, Cheetor almost dies. There's actually a cool dream sequence with a Generation 1 throwback little dream sequence where, was it Thundercracker that appeared in the dream? Why? It was Thundercracker or Skywarp. One of those two, but yeah, in jet mode. That was kind of random. But yeah, it's kind of cool. I like that stuff. And then Cheetor doesn't die, and Optimus, you see, here's the thing, though. The cadet, the youth, the rookie, messes up, and then the big boss man's grumpy. Optimus is grumpy at Cheetor. Bumblebee's grumpy at Strongarm in this episode because they tried to prove themselves. They tried to, you know, take control, and they mess up. You know, the inexperienced part gets to them. And they make an oopsie. So then what is the inexperienced character do? They try and redeem himself, like Strongarm does in this episode, like Cheetor did in that episode. You know, in this example, now that I think about it, Cheetor didn't really redeem himself. He didn't really redeem himself at all. He tries to go to their base to do something. He gets captured by Tarantulas and almost gets killed, and then Rattrap has to save him. And yeah, Rattrap shows up, busts up Tarantulas really good. Really good. He shoots his leg off, I think. Yeah, I gotta tell you, Beast Wars. Who did he say? What name is he saying? Tyrannus? I thought he said something else. An existing character. Anyway. I'm getting a little distracted. He doesn't, this, you know, my preference is a different voice for this guy. This just sounds a little generic to me, or just not fitting. Can I be picky? Hey, transformed into a car. Are those his only two modes? Eh. I guess. Remember, these are like Predacon Decepticons, right? Anyway, man, I got sidetracked. Yeah, Beast Wars had the best violence. Beast Wars and Transformers the Animated Movie, because there's so many deaths and destruction in that. Like, those are up at the top, you know? Not to say a show like Transformers Prime is nothing, but I just don't think, you know, it's Beast Wars, Transformers the Animated Movie, Transformers Prime a little lower as far as carnage and destruction goes, I feel. What else? What else had good stuff? Oh, so. Here, and yep. I'd be honored, Cadet. So, Strongarm, after making the mistake, she's like, give me one more shot. I know I can redeem. I know I can do it. Cheetor did not redeem. Cheetor messed up, got captured, had to get saved by Rat Trap, and then at the end, Rat Trap covered for Cheetor. Hey, he was just honking around. You know, Cheetor needed to have some space because you're so rough on him before. And Optimus is like, all right, carry on. So Rat Trap covered for him. What was the lesson learned in that episode? Now, there was another example with Cheetor in season one, early on season one. Can't remember the episode number, like six or something, you know. And I can't remember the title. It was like the Energon Storm. That was not the title, but the plot had to do with an Energon Storm that was ripping through, and at the same time, Cheetor was planting these Energon deposits, like several of them, he was creating some kind of, like, it was like a bomb. It was going to be a chain reaction of explosions to mess up the Predacon base, something like that. But an Energon Storm was coming through, and that was messing up their plans, because that's weather, right? So Optimus is like, scrub the mission, we got an Energon Storm, we can't do this right now, we'll have to wait for now. And Cheetor's like, no, man, no, blah, blah, blah. And he was at the base, and they had a big fight. Dinobot, you know, was there, and he's like, I want this to happen. I want to destroy all the Predacons. Let's use this situation to my advantage and manipulate Cheetor and then just going back out there and trying to finish this mission. So that's what he did, and that's what happened. And Cheetor went out, and he was planting one of the Energon deposit things into the ground, and it was struck by lightning, blah, 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 and then science happened, and Cheetor was transported. This caused an anomaly thing, and Cheetor was transported into the Predacon base. Like, it created a teleporter, this whole thing. So, Cheetor was like, whoa, I'm in the base, bruh. This is crazy. And then he was running around, trying to do stuff. And Optimus found out about this eventually, and he's like, oh, I'm grumpy again. And then the same thing happened to Pterosaur going to being transported to the Maximal base, and funny scenes happen, you know, comic stuff, comic relief stuff. And then Optimus is like, oh no, Dinobot, did you say Cheetor was destroyed because of what happened? And then Optimus is grumpy, and they want to avenge Cheetor, so they're gonna transport, use this new device as a transporter to teleport a bomb right into the Predacon base. And while Cheetor is there, he's trying to redeem himself, take advantage of his situation, his current situation. And he looks up knowledge, Predacon knowledge and whatever on their computers, on their ship's computers, and he discovers that if they blew up the Predacon base, it would cause a chain reaction that would destroy the Maximal base. Oh no! So then Cheetor kind of redeems himself in that episode, and he sends the information back, and the Maximals realize this, and basically the day is saved. They stop the bomb is sent, and then Cheetor has to stop the bomb from detonation at the Predacon base. And did I explain all this pretty good? So I, you know, that's more redeemable. Then in season three, Cheetor he goes through like cyber puberty, right, and all that stuff. And there was, he tries to prove himself again. He gets zapped by the Transmetal 2 driver, and that's where he gets more mature. And then in Beast Machines, he steps up into a more leader role. And that's what this episode was about, I guess. It's just going through the steps, right? Cadet, you're promoted to soldier, scout and soldier, and I don't know, lieutenant and general, whatever, commander, whatever words you want to use. But it's about going through the steps, going through the motions. And the episode has concluded, by the way. And that's what it's about. So, you know, it's not uncommon. So I use Cheetor as an example. What's another good example? What about Hotshot, right, from Transformers Armada? Yeah? I really can't think of anything. But yeah, I guess Hotshot. What about Transformers Prime? I don't know, man. Who would be the character? Bumblebee from Transformers Prime, or Wheeljack? No, Wheeljack, Bumblebee. I can't really think of a good one. Who am I not thinking of? Bulkhead? I don't know. I mean, because we're trying to think of that inexperienced and also kind of young character. Eh, so whatever. I'm sure you guys must have other examples. What about from Generation 1? Maybe Bumblebee from that one, or... I don't know, there wasn't... Really? Ooh, does that make... Spike! That was kind of Spike's role, I don't know. So yeah, there you go, guys. Another episode done, and... I don't know, hopefully I entertained you with talking about whatever the hell comes to my mind during the episode. It can range from Transformer conventions and... I try and bring up a couple of points from the episodes themselves. So, yeah, that's all I got. And once again, speaking about my update video, not only do I talk about my personal life, of course, but at the end of the update video, I do go over some a bit of Transformers news-related stuff that has to do with me and, I don't know, project-wise, like project material for my channel. So if you are interested... that's also in the update video, like in the last 10-ish, 15 minutes, something like that. So, if you want to check that out too, go for it. It's a good update video. It's a good update video. So that's all. That's all, folks. I want to thank you for joining me. The dog hair is blowing all over the place. Bailey is getting a haircut during his stay at the spa. Right, bud? Good boy. I hope you enjoyed the episode, Bailey. He has no idea what's going on. And I hope you guys enjoyed too. And when the following episodes air, I'm going to do what I've been doing. So good stuff, guys. I'll see you later. Transform and roll out!